Okay, all your bell work is due tomorrow. Late work is due today. So if there's any work that you need to turn in, make sure you get it in sometime today. All right, take a look up here. All of your weekly work is due tomorrow as well. All right, we're going to factor using the quadratic equation. So in a little while, sometime today, you're going to have a quiz just on the formula. So make sure you memorize this. Don't write it on my desk, okay? You can write it on your paper a few times and memorize it, but do not write it on my desk, okay? It's high school. You got to be accountable and you got to learn. All right, look up here. We got A, B, and C. So we're going to go ahead and factor. Well, to factor it, we're going to use the quadratic equation. So x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4 times a times c, all divided by 2 times a. Okay, there it is. So you're going to get negative 5 plus or minus the square root of 25. There's only one minus here, so it's going to be a negative. This is 4 times 4 is 16, and then 2 times 2 is 4. This right here is going to be 9, I think it is. So the square root of 9 is 3. So now you're going to have negative 5 plus 3 divided by 4 and negative 5 minus 3 divided by 4. There's your plus right here, and there's your minus right here. So you got two different answers here, okay? So in this one, you're going to get a negative 2 over 4, which reduces to a negative 1 half. Okay, that's one answer. On this one, you're going to get a negative 8 divided by 4, which is a negative 2. That's another answer. Okay, now, to write these as factored, what you're going to do on this one right here, you're going to use the bottom number to go with the x in the front. So this bottom number goes here. So it's going to be 2x, and then you do the opposite. Okay, so the opposite is going to be a plus 1, okay? And then here you're going to do the opposite, so that's going to be x plus 2. And that should work. You can actually check this one by using FOIL. Okay, put away your bell work. Let's try one more. Okay, I'm going to do one more with you, then I'm going to give you your worksheet. So try this one. Try 2x squared plus 11x plus 5. All right, use the quadratic equation and then write it as a factor. Okay, let's go over this. Watch what I do. You have A, B, and C. So x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4 times a times c, all divided by 2 times a. Okay, you're going to get a negative 11 plus or minus the square root of 121. This is only one negative, so it's going to be a minus. That's 8 times 5 is 40. So put 40, and then 2 times 2 is 4. Now this right here is 60, I think it's 81. So the square root of 81 is equal to 9. So it's going to be negative 11 plus 9 divided by 4, and negative 11 minus 9 divided by 4. Okay, we're almost done. This right here, 9, 10, 11, so that's going to be a negative 2 over 4, which reduces to a negative 1 half. So that's one answer. This right here is going to be a negative 20 over 4, which reduces to a negative 5. 4 goes into 20 5 times. So to write your answer on today's work, remember the bottom number goes in front. So it's going to be 2x, and then you got to do the opposite, plus 1, and then this one, the opposite, is going to be x plus 5. Okay? And that should be the answer for that problem. All right, let me just verify it for you. Okay. They have 2x plus 1 and x plus 5. So this is correct. Okay, so that's all you're going to do today is just some more quadratic equation and then using that to factor a trinomial, which is good exercise. All right. There's one more thing I want to show you on the PERT test, because some of you still need it. You're going to take each one of these factors and set them equal to 0 they will ask you for that. We're not going to do it today. But 2x plus 1 is equal to 0. Draw your line. You're going to subtract 1. So you get 2x is equal to a negative 1 and then divide by 2, and you got the answer that we started with. Okay, same thing here. X plus 5 is equal to 0. X is equal to a negative 5 because you got to bring the 5 over there, and that's what we had. Okay, just to show you, those are called roots or zeros. Okay, so these are your roots, or they call them zeros. Okay, it's where it crosses the x-axis. It's actually your x-intercept. Okay, have a good day.